Can smoking tobacco and drinking beer actually be good for you? Hey everyone, Crystal here for DNews. I think your mother and your doctor would both agree that smoking and drinking are not healthy habits. Something about lung cancer and cirrhosis of the liver. I don't know. But both tobacco and hops have a healthy little secret. They contain a high concentration of compounds that may help protect your brain cells against neurodegenerative disease. Both Parkinson's and Alzheimer's disease are major health concerns in the US. And these diseases are characterized by degeneration of neurons in the brain. And no small neurodegeneration, mind you. At the point that Parkinson's disease is usually diagnosed, over 50% of the neurons in the substantia nigra region of your brain already died. Research is currently being done to understand how we can best interfere with the progression of these diseases, and many a pharmaceutical company is hoping to develop drugs that don't just treat the symptoms, but that can actually protect our brains from cell death. Ironically, some of the most promising compounds being discovered are found in some pretty unhealthy places. Smoking continues to be a leading cause of preventable death worldwide, but nicotine, the addictive component found in tobacco smoke, may have neuroprotective properties. And trials are being performed to investigate the inverse correlation between smoking and Parkinson's disease. Weird, right? If you've ever smoked a conventional cigarette, you've lowered your risk for developing Parkinson's. A recent article published in the Journal of Agricultural and Food Chemistry identified another compound found in beer, Xanthohumol, as being potentially neuroprotective. When scientists challenged neuron-like cells grown in a dish with destructive oxidizers like peroxide, over 60% of the cells died. But when the cells were pre-treated with Xanthohumol, they showed 25% more viability than the cells not pre-treated. The researchers were also able to demonstrate that this was due to an increase in the cells' ability to defend themselves against stress, and not due to direct interactions between Xanthohumol and the oxidizing agent. Xanthohumol is emerging as something of a cure-all antioxidant, and it has already attracted attention due to its role in cardiovascular protection, as well as its anti-cancer, antiviral, anti-obesity, and anti-inflammation properties. And right now, high concentrations of the compound has only been found in beer. So hoppy beers and nicotine might be good for your brain, but be careful to stay in the lower end of exposure. Cancer, heart, and liver disease are a poor exchange for Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. And because I know some of you are going to ask, no, the two won't cancel each other out. No amount of anti-cancer and cardiovascular protection beer drinking will prevent the development of heart disease and lung cancer if you smoke like a chimney. What do you think? Is your lifestyle helping or hurting your brain? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments. And you can also find me on Twitter at PolyCrystalHD.